And you've made other horror films. You've also worked with some fantastic horror directors. Guillermo del Toro is one of the classic examples. Can you just talk about your experiences working with Guillermo and what makes him such a genius?
Yeah, working with Guillermo del Toro was probably, I don't know, it was amazing, really. And as a director, well, as an actor, working with a director like that who has an understanding of horror and seems to be able to sort of manipulate an audience so easily. It was just amazing. And Hellboy, although it's not a horror movie, it's sort of more comic book movie, there's certainly an element of, you know, adventure and an element of horror, actually. And if you see his other movies like Pan's Labyrinth or Cronus, you know, they're certainly edging towards horror. And Guillermo is just one of those extraordinary, imaginative people who lives in another world, really, and is able to bring, you know, from his imagination, bring to the real world, to movies, what he can see and what he imagines. And that's a great gift. And it was a real privilege to work with him. And he's an extraordinary man and a good mate.
I was always a little bit surprised that you weren't in the second Hellboy film, and I'm curious if there's a specific reason for that.
Well, to be honest with you, I was working, and that was what happened. So it was a bit of a clash of timings, really. And that's the truth of it. So I was gutted. They were in Budapest, and I was in Lithuania. So it was just one of those unfortunate things. But I will never forget Hellboy, the original, particularly Ron Perlman, who will always be like a father figure to me, and John Hurt, who was in the first movie and a little bit in the second. So for me, it was a real learning curve to be with such extraordinary, you know, masters of their craft.
I mean, we recently had a lovely chat with Ron where he confirmed his deep desire to make the third film in the series. He says he's fighting for that every day of his life. I'm curious, if there was a third film, assuming you could clear your schedule, would you like Agent Myers to come back?
No, any time that Guillermo works, there are probably three thousands of actors who would just give their left arm to work with Guillermo again, and I am one of those that, you know, will be forever grateful to him, and I would love to be on a set working with him, because he has such life. He is a life force, that man, and that's why he's a master of directing.
What do you think makes Hellboy stand out from all of the other kind of superhero kind of franchises that have kind of sprung up in the past 10 years, would you say?
Well, for me, when I read the Hellboy scripts and then read the comic, you know, the graphic novels, Mike Mignola's novels, for me, what I think sort of differentiates Hellboy to others is that the character of Hellboy has failings, and he is actually like an outsider living in, you know, a world with humans, and he is not one. And I think a lot of people identify with that sense of, you know, loneliness, a sense of being on the outside, trying to do good, but actually battles with himself. And it's that conflict, I think, that Hellboy possesses, which we all identify with, and we all want to be, you know, witness to and be a part of. And that's what I love about Hellboy, really. It's this extraordinary creature who's sawn off his horns. You know, he's an amazing kind of beast who struggles in life. And I think we all feel like that. So that's why I think Hellboy's fantastic. On set with Ron Perlman is, I can't explain it. It is sort of like a tornado. In those days, in the Hellboy days, you know, Hellboy smoked cigars, so I always will picture Ron, in full makeup. And it took him hours in the morning, and I used to sit next to him, in the makeup trailer with Jake, his makeup artist, and he'd have a cigar and telling me the most amazing stories. So that's what I remember, his incredible patience and humility, really, to get through it and then do this extraordinary performance, particularly the relationship between him and Selma Blair. I will forever remember that, because he is not only a very funny man, but a great actor.